November 7th, 2013, and me and Attila are at Delaney Park here at the most northern terminus of the Knobstone Trail. We're waiting for our shuttle. We're going to go all the way down to Deem Lake, and then we're going to hike back up here about 45, 43 miles and all. We're not going to be doing the extra loop. Haven't been on the Knobstone Trail in, almost 20 years. Looking forward to it. Waiting on the shuttle. Here we are. There's the sunshine. Waiting on the shuttle. Water drop number one. Load the trailhead. Right up there. Hope we make it back here. We will. Here we go. We're on the trail. Well, we're really not. This is the new trailhead because the other one was severely damaged by the tornado. Nothing here. Nothing to tell us if we're on the right place or not. We don't know. We're only hoping. Well, guess what? We're not on the right trail. Okay, we're on the right trail now. Yeah! It only took us 2 miles to figure it out. The sign says KT reroute. Only, guess what? We found it on the ground. And it's right at an intersection. We're not sure. That's a red blaze. See it? Red blaze? Yeah, guess what? The Knobstone's white blaze. Mile marker number 3. Lunchtime on the Knobstone Trail. So what am I having? Salmon, roll-ups, and some candy. Pretty good stuff. All right, so we're like at mile, I don't know, 4.5 maybe? Round knobs up ahead of us.
14.
We're at mile, no we're not. No, he's making that up. We are not mile 14. We kind of got misdirected there at the beginning, so we're a little off schedule. That will be okay. Beautiful day. It's it's barely 50. Tons and tons of blowdowns. Acres and acres of blowdowns. This is from that big tornado they had. We were told that it was just pretty much all cleared out. They have opened up the section with a lot of down trees for logging, which, you know, makes sense as opposed to just letting them rot. Here we go, here's a close-up of that tornado destruction. It sure knocked down a lot of trees. Yellow tape. Must be on the trail, all right. Ain't seen a piece of white tape, though, have we? Well, 108 feet. above sea level. Not the highest point in Indiana, still pretty high. Climbing around, Knob. We can actually see Louisville right over there. You can, but we can. And you can see where this Knobstone escarpment drops off. And beyond Louisville is the Cumberland Plateau, at least the bloody knife edge of it. This isn't a bad climb, nothing like Colorado. This is what gives the Knobstone its name. This Knobstone shale, which is a limestone. Don't carve your initials in it like Jay Stupid Hall did there. Okay? Or PH, or... anyway, don't do that. That's stupid. Whoa, check this out. Mile marker number 6. Yeah! More tornado damage. Top around, Knob. Whoa. O'clock, folks, can we make it to our water drop before dark? Oh yeah. Can we make it to mile 10 before dark? We're gonna try. Yeah. Trail condition report. Yeah, between mile 0 and so far mile 8, the trail is very clear. Of course, we're getting back into the tornado damage. Well, we're saying goodbye to that tornado damage, we hope. There's the last of it. Quite a bit back there. A little bit of gravel road walking here. Mile marker number 8. Say you see Louisville again?
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah, we're getting close to mile 10. Quite a climb, especially with 8 pounds of water on your back. Whoo! I tell you what. The Knobstone Trail's starting to impress me. Take a look at this. Wow. For tonight, camp the first night. You know, this is November 7th, Thursday. It's about, what, almost 5:30. Getting kind of dark, as you can see. We're way up high, probably about 1,150 feet, something like that. This is Marco's Foster's Lager beer can. He made that himself. It's a little beer can pot, right, Marco?
Mm-hmm.
Very nice. We're going. We're splitting. We're hitting the road. Beautiful sunshine. Check it out. Huh? Great night. Still some stuff in the lower elevations there, fog and things, but we're up high. Here we go. Coming up on Route 160. If you look over there, see the top of that hill? I know you can. That's where we're heading. That's like mile marker 12. Down the hills, and up the hill, and down the hill. Yeah, here's a good down. Woo. Pushing mile 12 here. Attila had a little problem with one of his water bottles. Started leaking. I had a spare, so we're good to go. Yeah, not so bad. We thought that climb out of 160 would be bad. It was minor. There's a lot of briars up on top up here. A lot of those wild roses. Still isn't bad. I mean, you know, we've only had to go through two blowdowns, maybe three. So we're doing good. And here we go, mile marker 13. 11 more miles for us today. So Till is getting him some pretty water, he says. Look at that. Fighting the briars here. So, been flat for a long ways though. Plenty of water. I don't know. Starting to doubt the DNR about there not being any water here at all. But I'm sure it dries up. But not now. Your standard DNR probationary sign. No horseback riding ATVs, motorcycles, or bicycles. You can just walk here. Didn't say anything about canoeing. Lunchtime. So what you have in there, Mr. Attila, sir?
Tater chips.
Tater chips. Eat anything else besides tater chips?
Nope.
New Chapel Trailhead, or at least kinda. Actually, if you look at the sign, the New Chapel Trailhead is up there at about a half mile. And this is where the Knobstone Trail proper crosses this road here. Look, isn't that neat? Check it out, water and beer. So we got an H2O and a beer angel. We just passed mile marker 17. Means we got 7.5 miles to go to our food drop and water drop. Well, blazing kind of sucks here in between 17 and 18. Close to mile 18 now. There's a pretty confusing intersection back there. There's no double blazes. There's none of those carbonite or whatever the heck they call those little plastic sticks they stick in the ground.
Oh well, I'll do another one.
See? I can cut. marker number 21. That makes 11.25 miles for us today and 3.5 miles to Laodi and our food and where we're going to camp. Stop doing it. Now, come on. Hi. So here we are on the Knobstone Trail. It's Friday, November 8th, and did you really do that?
What? What? I didn't do anything.
Anyway, we're taking a break. We're at 22.5. We're going to go to 24.5. Marco says we're going to go to 25 and make it an even 15.25 miles in like, oh God, we started at 8:30. It's 4 o'clock, but we got to get going. I think we hear some. I don't hear anybody. Attila says he hears somebody coming. There's number 23. Mile and a half to go. A 24 already, yeah, one more mile, huh? One more mile? Yeah, we have another mile in me. I think I do. This is probably another one of these situations where somebody came in. Yeah, it's an abandoned tent. We found, this has got to be my sixth or seventh one. And just so that you know, generally there's never anything of value in there. And this one even had a heat sheet as a ground cloth. Look at that. So if you hike in Indiana, eventually, no matter what long distance trail you do, you're gonna do some road walking. Not very far. The Laodi Trailhead. That much to look at, huh? Mile 24.5 and 14.75. For those of you not decimal orientated, that's 14.75 miles today. Of course, Marco Attila, he wants to go on to mile marker 25 after we get our food. Got a food drop. Got my food drop. Marco's got his water drop. Also got a beer drop. Ha! There it is. Mile marker 25. That puts us at 15.25 miles today. And guess what? I'm done. So here's our camp. Right here. There's a fire ring. Yeah. Take a look at this. Let's see if I can't get that smudge off there tomorrow. Yeah, it's high. It's heavy. It is really windy.
It is so windy.
Didn't pick up till about an hour ago. 8 o'clock and we're out of camp. Wow, was it windy up there. Easily some 45, maybe 50 mile an hour gusts. So we are going to go down into the hollow here and we're going to eat a quick breakfast. Mile 28.75, no more water drops for us. There ought to be plenty of water between here and Delaney Lake Park. We're gonna stop at Elk Creek, which I believe I can see it, and get some water there. And I think there's Spurgeon Hollow. I'll look at the map. I don't have any ammo. Look at the size of this burl. It's on an oak tree, so it's an oak burl. This thing is gigantic. It's easily 4 foot in diameter. Probably, oh my God, it's huge. There you go. That is the biggest burl I've ever seen. Hell of a climb here between 28 and 29. Not terrible, but I think it's the fifth one we've hit since 25.5. And they are steep. And they're not very well switchbacked. And the whole section is not terribly well blessed. Windy on these ridges. I mean, it's gonna be windy all day. We're coming up on Elk Creek. Get some water there. Take a little break and a snack. Right on cue, here's Elk Lake, Elk Creek Lake, excuse me. I guess they dammed up Elk Creek. I bet there's no elk down here at all. Well, I'm on the wrong side of the lake. Got to do a little bit of backtracking, not much. I didn't see where it went. Elk Creek Lake. So you haven't seen mile marker 31 yet. It may not be here, this much people here. There you go, Elk Creek Lake. Cool. Mile marker 32. And we're gonna go to 40.5. So that means how many miles left? 8.5. Wow, another long, nasty climb. Straight up and straight down. Ew. Pretty neat though, except for the power lines, huh? We think this is 56. Oh, hey, here's this reroute. Oh, boy. We've got back on the Knobstone from a little detour. We don't see any place that the detour comes back in or goes back out. It looks like it's very poorly marked for this direction. Okay, we're on that Knobstone reroute thing. Check it out. For those of you who don't know, let's look here. Pink and black diagonal striped tape and white blazes. Basically, there is no trail. We are just cutting our way through the woods. Reroute complete. We're back on the Knobstone. It wasn't that long at all. Maybe 2 miles. Maybe even that far. All right, no trespassing. So we won't. Somebody's anal about trespass. Little more road walking. I nice little country gravel road here. We think we're heading towards the John Stewart Oxley Memorial Trailhead.
Tell you, I'm going to let the narrator tell you something about John Stewart Oxley because I really don't know anything about him right now.
It turns out that John Stewart Oxley was an avid outdoorsman who frequently used the Knobstone Trail.
So, this is Saturday Night's Camp. That's right. About 8:20, we're almost done here. Good night in the woods. I slept cowboy style and got a little damp. Saw a whole lot of shooting stars though, which was really tough. Mile marker 40, 5.5 miles in the car, and guess what? We're gonna go uphill. We're on the Spurgeon Hollow Loop, heading towards Delaney Lake. Hey deer hunters! Well, there's a heck of a scrape line on this trail. We've already passed like 7 and they're all super fresh. This would be a good place to put a deer stand too. Mile marker 42. We're really starting to put them down now. The car is 3.5 miles away. Mile 43,
yeah.
2.5 miles. I believe this is Spurgeon Hollow Lake. Or it could be just Spurgeon Hollow, but anyway, there's a lake here. Very pretty lake, Spurgeon Hollow Lake. Oh yeah, there's a climb out of Spurgeon Hollow. Straight up for about 160 feet. So far, just that one big climb between 40 and 45.5. Remember, we are going to Delaney Lake Trail, so we didn't do the Spurgeon Hollow Loop because it's closed. Well, almost done. Then probably a half mile to go. Got a little head of Attila there, so I'm kind of waiting on him. Lots of big white pines right in here. 45.5. Half mile to the car. Here we go. Delaney Lake. 35.5 miles on the Knobstone Trail. Not the entire thing, because we couldn't do the Spurgeon Hollow Loop, but close enough, close enough. Really good hike. Enjoyed it. We hit our weather window real good. Knobstone's got some hills, nothing major, nothing that anybody with any experience can't handle. So here we go. There's the parking lot. All right. You get a chance, and you haven't done it, you should try the Knobstone. Try doing it all. Special thanks to Joe Campbell at Go Deep Outfitters for giving us the shuttle. All right, you guys have a good day, and I'll see you later.